Today we will discuss the concept of the centre of mass. The centre of mass is a position or unique point in a mass distribution where all the mass is supposed to be concentrated. Consider a ball having a uniform mass distribution. Where do you think the position of the centre of mass will be? Consider two metal balls of different masses, connected through a rod. Where do you think the centre of mass of this system will be? We'll find the answers to all these questions in this video. The centre of mass of a system of particles is the unique point where all the mass of the particles is assumed to be concentrated. It's not like all the mass is concentrated at that point, but it is supposed to be concentrated. The general mathematical definition of the center of mass of a system of particles is the point relative to which the weighted position vectors of all the particles sums to zero. Mathematically, the sum of the product of mi and the difference of vector ri and vector r, going from I equals 1 to n, which is equals to zero. Here, mi represents the mass of each particle in the system of n particles. Vector ri is the position vector of each particle, and vector r represents the center of mass of the system. Rearranging the above equation for center of mass, vector r. Vector r is equals to the product of mi and vector ri, going from I equals 1 to n, divided by the sum of mi going from I equals 1 to n. Take the sum of mi going from I equals 1 to m, which is equals to capital M, where m is the total mass of all the particles. Therefore, vector r equals the product of mi and vector ri going from I equals 1 to n, divided by capital M. The center of mass can be calculated by finding its x and y coordinates separately. Consider a system of n particles with masses m1, m2, m3 through to mn, with position coordinates x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3 through to xn, yn respectively. The x and y coordinates of the center of mass of the system will be xcm equals m1x1 plus m2x2 plus m3x3 till mnxn divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3 till mn. ycm equals m1y1 plus m2y2 plus m3y3 till mnyn divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3 till mn. In case of continuous mass distribution, xcm is equals to 1 divided by m, integration over xdm. ycm is equals to 1 divided by m, integration over ydm. Here, m equals integration over dm. Due to symmetry, the center of mass of rigid bodies having uniform mass density lies at the centroid of the body. In case of objects with non-uniform mass density, the center of mass depends on the density distribution. Do not assume that center of mass of a rigid object always lies inside the object. For instance, in case of a ring, the center of mass lies at its geometric center, where there is no real mass distribution. Consider three objects of uniform mass density, with masses 1 kg, 2 kg, and 5 kg, placed in an XY plane at locations 4 meters, 1 meter, 5 meters, 4 meters, and 2 meters, 7 meters respectively. Now find the center of mass of the system. First, find the X coordinate of the center of mass by taking the X coordinates of the given masses. XCM equals m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus m3 x3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3, which is equals to 1 kg times 4 meters plus 2 kg times 5 meters plus 5 kg times 2 meters divided by 1 kg plus 2 kg plus 5 kg, which is equals to 3 meters. Now find the y-coordinate of the center of mass by taking the y-coordinates of the given masses. YCM is equals to m1 y1 plus m2 y2 plus m3 y3 divided by m1 plus m2 plus m3, which is equals to 1 kilogram times 1 meter plus 2 kilograms times 4 meters plus 5 kilograms times 7 meters divided by 1 kilogram plus 2 kilograms plus 5 kilograms, which is equals to 5.5 meters. Hence, the center of mass of the system is at 3 meters and 5.5 meters. For solving problems involving the motion of rigid bodies, we consider the motion of the center of mass. All the external forces are assumed to be applied at this point. Any external force applied at the center of mass causes linear acceleration. There is no angular acceleration at this point. We hope that the concept of the center of mass is clear to you. For a better understanding, try some practice problems to have a good command of the concept.